Okay, now we're going to talk about something called differentials. This is kind of a strange concept. We've seen things like f prime of x equals dy dx before, and we've seen that dy dx is approximately change in y over change in x. But do dy and dx by themselves have any meaning? It turns out that we can talk about them having meaning. You can almost think of them as infinitely little small changes in y's and changes in x. But in the context of linear approximation, we can be even more specific about what we mean by dy and dx. We can say that dy and dx are actually the amount that the linear approximation changes. So if this is our point x, and this is our point x plus change in x. So what I mean by that is this is the point where it's easy to plug in, and this is the point we want to know about. And we would really like to know this value right here. The easy thing to find is f of x. We really want to know f of x plus change in x. So why am I calling it x plus change in x? It's kind of like that whole x plus h idea before. The change in x is how far x has changed from the point where we actually are calculating the exact value to this point we want. Well then, we can define, in this context, once we draw in this tangent line approximation, these two little green line segments to be dy and dx. The amount that y changes in the approximation is dy, and the amount that x changes in the approximation on the tangent line is dx. Now contrast that with delta x, which we just talked about, which is how much x changes. You can see that those are actually the same, dx and delta x. But then if we talk about delta y, which is how much y has changed, that's this value here, or on the graph over, you can write it over here. Delta y is the real amount of change in the y value from on the function from the point that we know to the point we want. Whereas dy right here is the amount of change between the y value of the point we want and the y value of our approximation. So in this context, dy and dx, these differentials, have a very specific meaning. And you can see that dy over dx in this context is exactly the slope of the tangent line because it's just change in y over change in x. So we get the equation that we expect, that dy dx is the same thing as f prime of x. Now we can actually take that equation I just wrote, that dy dx is the same as f prime of x, and solve that for dy. So we get dy is f prime of x times dx. And that actually gives us a formula to calculate dy easily, because we are assuming that we know how to find f prime at this function value x, which is the easy value. And we are assuming that we can figure out this change between the point we want and the point we would like, which we could call x plus change in x, or we could call this x plus dx, because dx and change in x are the same. So here it tells you dx is the same as delta x, but dy is not the same as delta y. So dy, we just said what that formula would be. In contrast, what would the formula be for delta y? Well, delta y is how far you are from the actual point where you want to be, so that would be f of x plus delta x, the actual y value of the point you want, how far away is that from the y value of the point that's easy to find? And so that number is an exact amount of change versus dy, where that's an estimate. The problem with delta y is that f of x plus delta x is going to be hard to find in many situations where you would want to do actual approximation. So that's why we use dx, dy, to approximate it instead. So So here's an example. It says compare dy and delta y at the value x equals 2 for delta x is 1 and delta x is 0.01 using the function x squared plus 2x. Now this is going to be kind of a silly example to use linear approximation on because we can just plug in the numbers. But in order to actually compare dy to delta y, we need to be able to find delta y, which means we need to actually be able to plug in the numbers into our function. So let's try this. We know that we can find dy by taking the derivative, which is 2x plus 2, and multiplying it by dx. Now plugging in the numbers that we have for our particular situation, dy is x is 2, change in x is 1. So we get 2 times 2 plus 2 times dx is the same as change in x, so that'll be 1. So this is 4 plus 2, 6 times 1 is 6. Now if we want to calculate change in y, that is actually f of x plus, let's write that down first, f of x plus delta x minus f of x. So that's going to be f of 2 plus 1 minus f of 2, which is f of 3 minus f of 2. Now we can actually calculate those values, so we're looking at 3 squared plus 2 times 3 minus 2 squared plus 2 times 2. So calculating those, we get 9 plus 6 minus 4 minus 4, which is 7. So we estimated that the change would be 6, that was our dy, and the actual change was 7. So we're not that far off. Now let's try this again at x equals 2 and delta x equals 0.1, just to make sure we've got this solid. So we've got dy equals f prime of x dx, so dy equals 2x plus 2 times dx, so dy equals 2 times 2 plus 2, plugging in 2 for x, times now our change in x is going to be 0.1, so this is 6 times 0.1, so 0.6. And then comparing that with the actual change in y, which is f of x plus change in x minus f of x, which is f of 2 plus 0.1 minus f of 2, which is f of 2.1 minus f of 2, which is 2.1 squared plus 2 times 2.1 minus 2 squared plus 2 times 2. So what does that give us? Delta y is, maybe we want our calculator, 0.61. So now that we're closer to the point where we actually did the estimate, our delta y is 0.61. And our dy is 0.6, so you can see that when our point is that we care about, in this case 2.1, is closer to the point that we know how to find, which in this case would be 2, then our dy is closer to our actual change in y. So this is how you compute dy and change in y.